Today, we'll talk about which are the 5 best picks, how to choose the correct product, and what you should look at before buying. We've ranked these products based on their price, quality, durability, performance, and more. If you'd like to see their price and find out more information, you can check out the links in the description down below. Let's get started. Moving up, we have the most versatile model out there. Let's take a look.
Number 5, Logitech G600. The Logitech G600 MMO gaming mouse is one of the finest gaming mice in the market. If you're looking for a mouse with more programmable buttons than you've got fingers, the G600 is well worth the price tag. The G600 has a few advantages over the competition, starting with an extra 3 buttons. In addition to 12 buttons on the right side of the mouse, the left and right mouse buttons, and 2 additional buttons up top, the G600 sports an extra button that sits below your pinky. The G600 registers pushing the mouse wheel to the left or right in addition to the standard button selection when you push down the wheel itself. In terms of comfort, the G600 is a delight for anyone with a palm grip. Since the thumb controls 12 of its 20 buttons, there's no groove for the thumb. Rather, the index finger controls the left button, the middle finger controls the right button, and the ring finger rests on a 3rd button that activates the mouse's macro controls. At 133 grams, the G600 is a bit heavier than the standard gaming mouse, and it's quite a bit bulkier too. However, the heft makes the mouse feel substantial and satisfying to use. Those who prefer to use claw or fingertip grips, you should take heed. This is not the mouse for you. Claw users will find their grip inefficient, while fingertip users won't be able to click the left button at all. Having more than 100 button combinations at the tip of your thumb is a useful and versatile feature, especially for higher level MMO players. That said, familiarizing yourself with the Logitech G600's sea of buttons and tweaking them to perfection require a great deal of time, effort, and patience. Dealing with the mushy middle buttons also makes hitting the right one during a pitched battle a little tougher than it should be. Gamers who need every advantage they can get for their high-level MMO play would be wise to check out this mouse.
If you hate wires, then this next product is a great option for you, because it's our best wireless pick.
Number 4. Logitech G305. The G305 is a no-nonsense product in the sense that it doesn't have any LEDs or weird design elements. It's a simple egg-shaped mouse with a grey-silver Logitech logo towards the back of the unit. Logitech has already produced a variety of wireless mice, ranging from the pretty good to the truly exceptional. The Logitech G305 is right in the middle of the pack. It's not quite ambitious enough to cover uncharted ground, but more than a match for the everyday trials and tribulations of PC gaming and productivity. This small, sleek, intuitive gaming mouse works wonderfully and couldn't be easier to use. Those who want a no-frills wireless gaming mouse from a major manufacturer without digging too deeply in their wallets will find a lot to like here. The mouse measures about 4.5 by 2.5 inches and stands only 1.5 inches tall. The mouse works for both palm and claw grip players, and at only 3.4 ounces, it's one of the lighter full-sized wireless mice out there. The G305 uses Logitech's proprietary Hero sensor, which has the same performance as their lauded 3366 unit, but delivers these performances at 10 times the efficiency, making it ideal to put in wireless mice. It's a fantastic mouse with a flawlessly performing sensor, super satisfying clicks, and an impressive battery life of 250 in-game hours on one AA battery. It weighs in at 96 grams, but it feels lighter than that because of the fact that it's wireless. You can easily reduce the weight if you use a AAA battery with a converter as well, if you want an even freer feeling. Almost everything about the G305 is superb, but the shape is somewhat polarizing. It's not the most comfortable mouse out there, and it's also pretty small, ruling out most people with large hands, certainly if you're a palm gripper. And some people can't even use the G305 due to the way the sides are shaped. Overall, at under $50, you won't find a better wireless gaming mouse.
If you're looking for a mid-range model, then this next pick is a great option.
Number 3. SteelSeries Rival 310. Competitive gamers need a mouse that can keep up with fast-paced action. At just under $50, the right-handed ergonomic SteelSeries Rival 310 promises to deliver responsive performance for the esports crowd, as well as most other gamers. The Rival 310 has a simple, clean design, and it has just about everything one should expect from a gaming mouse. Two main buttons, a clickable scroll wheel, two thumb buttons, and a DPI switch. There's even two zones of RGB lighting, with the SteelSeries logo and the scroll wheel both being independently lit. The SteelSeries Rival 310 combines a modest matte design with a good number of features. All six of its buttons are programmable, but you'll most likely want to keep the default actions for the right and left buttons, as well as the scroll wheel. Otherwise, the DPI switcher and the two side navigation buttons offer good opportunities for customization. The SteelSeries TrueMove 3 sensor, which is specifically engineered for esports gaming, offers one-to-one tracking between 100 and 3500 DPI and promises reduced jittering between 3500 and 12,000 DPI. Thanks to this new sensor and its wired connection, you won't experience any input lag, and movements across all applications will feel smooth and natural. The performance of the Rival 310 is second to none at this price point. From the moment I started using the 310, I was genuinely blown away with how it felt. I've covered nearly all of the new mouse releases this year, but nothing has felt smoother or more natural. If you want to tweak the mouse's performance, you'll boot up SteelSeries Engine. You can change the DPI setting, adjust the button configuration, and customize the RGB lighting there. Definitely a great mid-range gaming mouse.
Before we talk about the best model overall, let's look at the runner-up for this list.
Number 2. Razer Death Adder Essential. If you're an avid gamer, you've probably heard this word combination before. It's one of the most well-known product lines in gaming mice. Since its first release in 2006, millions have been sold, many online and offline competitions have been won, and hundreds of thousands of gaming hours have been played with Death Adders. The Essential is the latest and currently cheapest iteration of this lineup, which means its features are not as great as they are on the Elite, which is the current flagship. This mouse features a PixArt PAW3328 mid-level optical sensor, main switches rated for 10 million clicks, textured plastic side grips, and non-chroma green lighting. The Death Adder Essential features a 6400 DPI sensor and is wired, meaning it's both quick and latency-free. For both gaming and day-to-day usage, it's a pleasure to use. The Essential, just like all Death Adders, except for the left-handed edition, is a right-handed ergonomic gaming mouse with side buttons on the left side only. It has a relatively high profile with a rather tall middle part that nicely fills out your palm if you have medium-sized hands. As for its size, it's a medium-large model, so it might not be suitable for all users with small hands. Weight-wise, the Death Adder Essential is quite great. It weighs 94 grams, which is average for its size, especially if we look at the competition. The mouse is also well-balanced. It's neither rear nor front-heavy. Generally, a lightweight mouse is better for your wrists in the long run, which means it could afford to be even a bit lighter, but thankfully it's far from being heavy. There are no doubts that the Razer Death Adder Essential is a brilliant mouse for the money, especially given its legendary status and fantastic performance thanks to that 6400 DPI sensor. I've personally used a Death Adder Essential for more than 100 hours so far, and I definitely love it.
Finally, the next model is the best overall. From us, it gets a perfect score in all categories.
Number 1. Logitech G502 Hero. When it comes to gaming peripherals, you basically can't go wrong with Logitech. The Logitech G502 Hero features the 1000Hz polling rate and 1 millisecond response time as expected from a proper gaming mouse, and we hardly notice any shortcomings in this department. But the Hero sensor is what helps the mouse shine. The Hero sensor offers flawless tracking, it supports a DPI range from 100 to 16,000, though I found the upper limit largely unimportant. What matters is how well it responds to your hand movements and how consistent it is. Basically, while using this mouse, I've never noticed any odd mouse movements, and thanks to tracking at max speeds over 400 inches per second and max accelerations over 40 Gs, it'll be hard to push this mouse past its limit. The switches underneath the buttons feel great, giving a responsive click with minimal actuation force. There's enough resistance to keep you from misclicking while resting your finger or fingers on the buttons, but none feel too squishy. Logitech's customization software is fairly easy to use and highly advised for a mouse with this many buttons. To make the most of the G502 Hero, you really need to have a plan for all the buttons. The Logitech G502 is bigger and heavier than I'd recommend to most gamers, and I think Logitech and other mouse companies have surpassed its design in the years since it first released. But it remains a great gaming mouse with features few competitors offer, and with a new sensor that'll keep the G502 competitive with anything released in the next 5 years. It's still the best choice for a large, heavy gaming mouse around. It weighs 121 grams with an additional 18 grams addable with some small metal weights that fit into the bottom of the chassis. The G502 does feel solid. A good bit of that weight comes from the metal scroll wheel, which has such a wonderfully smooth and satisfying scroll feel under your finger, it'll be hard to go back to any mouse that doesn't have it. If you're after performance at any cost, this is the best G502 on the market. Buying guide. Firstly, play styles. The gaming mouse requirements depend on the type of game that you play. Consequently, the game that you intend to play will determine the features that you consider the most important for your gaming mouse. For example, RTS and MMO gamers will require additional buttons that can be assigned to alternative functions and macros, compared to FPS gamers who focus on accuracy and quick tracking. Secondly, wired or wireless. In the past, wireless mice were considered to have slow responsiveness needed for high-speed, octane, and reactive games. However, improved technology has enabled wireless gaming mice to function the same as wired. The significant difference is the price of the two. Wireless gaming mice are considered to be more expensive compared to wired. Thirdly, grip style. Most gamers use fingertip, claw, or palm grip styles to enhance their gaming experience. The type of mouse grip style is essential because it determines the weight and shape of the mouse that you find to be most comfortable. And fourthly, DPI. DPI refers to the rate of pixels your screen cursor will move per inch of movement on the mouse. Consequently, the size of your screen will determine the appropriate DPI. If you have a larger screen, you need a higher DPI mouse because it results in a more significant mouse movement on the screen per inch of the progress of your mouse. This process can enhance your gaming experience.
Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.